Welcome, brothers and sisters. This is the pre-recorded devotional, which is all about youth. Thank you for your time to watch this devotional. So we will start with our youth as they recite the young men theme, the young women theme, and the youth theme for 2021. Then, I invite all of you to pray in your own home or location.
Beloved Son of God, and He has a work for me to do.
With all my heart, might, mind, and strength, I will love God, keep His covenants, and use His priesthood to serve others, beginning in my own home.
As I strive to serve, exercise faith, repent, and improve each day, I will qualify to receive temple blessings and the enduring of joy of the gospel.
I will prepare to become a diligent missionary, loyal husband, and loving father by true disciple of Jesus Christ.
I will help prepare the word for the Savior's return by inviting all to come unto Christ and receive the blessing of His atonement.
Beloved daughter of heavenly parents, with a divine nature and eternal destiny.
As a disciple of Jesus Christ, I strive to be like Him.
I seek and act upon personal revelations and minister to others in His holy name.
I will stand as a witness of God at all times and in all things and in all places.
I strive to qualify for exaltation. I cherish the gift of repentance and seek to improve each day.
Faith, I will strengthen my home and family, make and keep sacred covenants, receive the ordinances and blessings of the Holy Temple.
And out of small things proceeded that which is great.
This devotional is all about youth, and as your leader, it is my duty to teach the things which I feel is needful. But first, let me be very clear, the primary responsibility for a rising generation lies with us, parents. So let us consider the following scriptures regarding this very important principle.
And again, inasmuch as parents have children in Zion, or in any of her stakes which are organized that teach them not to understand the doctrine of repentance, faith in Christ, the Son of the living God.
And of baptism and the gift of the Holy Ghost by the laying on hands, when 8 years old, the sin be upon the hands of the parents.
And the inhabitants of Zion also shall remember their labors inasmuch as they are appointed to labor in all faithfulness.
For the idler shall be had in remembrance before the Lord.
Now I, the Lord, am not well pleased with the inhabitants of Zion, for there are idlers among them.
And their children are also growing up in wickedness.
They also seek not earnestly the riches of eternity, but their eyes are full of greediness.
You have not taught your children light and truth according to the commandments, and that wicked one hath power as yet over you, and this is the cause of your affliction.
But I have commanded you to bring up your children in light and truth.
And now a commandment I give unto you, if you will be delivered, you shall set in order your own house.
For there are many things that are not right in your house.
Brothers and sisters, my purpose for this devotional is to provide you a glimpse of the inspired programs and counsels our church has to offer to our rising generation. These initiatives are anchored on developing a strong bond of our youth with their Heavenly Father, Jesus Christ, family, and others through worthwhile activities and service opportunities. Ang una po sa list natin, brothers and sisters, ay ito pong Children and Youth Program. So ito po ay napakaganda na programa para sa ating mga kabataan at tuturuan po ang ating mga youth na ma-develop ang kanilang sarili in four areas. So gaya ng sinabi dito sa introduction, this personal development guidebook offers principles and tools that our youth can use in their efforts to develop their gifts and follow Jesus Christ. So I hope nakakita na tayo nito and we are helping our youth to use this booklet for their personal development. So this is a pattern of growth and development as exemplified by the Savior Jesus Christ. As we can read in Luke chapter 2 verse 52, Jesus increased in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and man. So as you can see, ang ating mga youth ay encouraged to make goals and plans in four areas of their life, no? Spiritual, social, physical, and intellectual. So this is one very important tool that our youth can use to develop themselves and prepare themselves for their future responsibilities. Next in our list is seminary every day. So as you know, we have seminary for grade school students and then we have institute para sa ating mga college students. So I cannot overemphasize the importance of seminary as you always hear me, no? And encourage ating mga youth na mag-seminary. Of course, according to their own free will. No? So I am counting really on the support of our parents and the family of our youth to really be able to do seminary every day. Alam ko po yung challenge na meron ng mga youth ngayon with the online schooling that we have now and the modules that we have. They are very busy and I know they are striving to keep up, no, dun sa kanilang mga napakaraming gagawin. And I also understand yung mga parents sa kanilang sacrifices as they help, no, yung kanilang mga anak to finish yung kanilang mga modules, yung kanilang online schooling requirement. But then again, I know na importante to have balance sa buhay ng ating mga youth, that as they learn secular knowledge, they also learn doctrines and principles that come from the scriptures and from the words of the living prophets. In our previous devotional for youth, si Sister Emmy Cortez shared her testimony of the importance and blessing of seminary to her two children. So let us listen to a mother's testimony of seminary every day.
I'd like also to touch on seminary class. Sorry po parents, pero talagang at this point in time, yung active pagiging active po ng mga anak nyo sa seminary, sana po sa inyo na rin po manggaling kung nakikita nyo hindi sila ganun ka-active sa seminaries. Kasi, I would like to cite example kasi wala naman ako ibang masasite kundi sa mga anak ko. Si Arman Job Cortez po, yung panganay kong lalaki. kung I hope hindi siya magagalit sa akin, pero elementary, ang mga grades po niyan is talagang pasang-awa. Nasa line of 7 yan lahat halos. 79, 77, 78, 76, 75. But when he started going to seminary, amazing. Kasi nag-graduate siya ng high school as a top 5 sa kanyang klase. Which is, I always, inasabi ko lagi yun na I owe it to his seminary class. Kasi mas na-enrich yung mind. Sabi nga, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all these things shall be added unto you. So na-enrich yung mind niya sa seminary kasi mag-iisip ka, mag-research ka ng scriptures, and then may inspire ka. And it went hand in hand sa school niya. So, and as a parent naman po ang ginawa ko, I made sure na nagsiseminary sila. Sa akin, mas importante na nasa seminary class sila. Minsan pinapayagan ko pa yan mag-skip ng classes. And as long as hindi siya makaka-apekto sa growth niya sa school, pinapayagan ko yan kasi I want them to understand na although importante yung secular, mas importante yung spiritual knowledge kasi yun ang maghuhubog sa atin bilang tao, bilang anak ng Diyos. So yun po ang experience ko bilang leader at bilang nanay ng mga youth.
Another area where our youth can develop is through leadership experiences. I think this is the genius of the church, wherein yung ating mga youth, young as they are called to serve in leadership positions. So, you know, meron tayong mga priest quorum leaders, meron tayong deacons quorum presidency, meron tayong teachers quorum presidency, and then meron tayong young women class presidency. So all these are opportunities for our youth to develop their leadership skills. So imaginein po ninyo na age 11, 12, 13, 14, they are asked to take assignments and the opportunity to develop from doing their calling sa simbahan. So meron nga isang nag-share in one of the area trainings kung paano nakatulong yung leadership experience ng ating mga young men sa kanilang paghahanap ng trabaho. Because they were taught to make a very powerful resume. So, nilagay nila doon yung kanilang callings as Deacons Quorum President at age 12, 13, and then Teachers Quorum Counselor, and then all other callings as they were growing up, no, sa church. So, yung mga nag-i-interview, they took note of inclusion, no, ng ganitong experience. And they were asked to explain kung ano ibig sabihin nun because they do not know. No? So, yung mga members natin, yung mga young single adults natin, they would explain na we were asked to lead a group of young men, no, sa mga activities, we help prepare sa mga activities, and many things, ano? So, na-amaze yung mga nag-i-interview. And that was a positive point, no? Para doon sa mga nag-a-apply ng trabaho na mga members natin who had leadership experience sa simbahan. Kaya, when they are called, karaniwan, our parents are asked, no? Na kung papayagan ba nila or kung isusustain ba nila yung kanilang anak when they are called or ordained to a particular position sa simbahan. So, that is the reason na we are asked as parents, no, to sustain yung ating mga anak as they are called and encourage them to magnify their responsibilities. So, sabi nga dito, no, in a quotation by Elder Jeffrey R. Holland, we underestimate their ability and overestimate their experience. So, napakahalaga na, no, na Minsan, minamaliit natin yung ating mga youth. Hindi natin na nare-recognize yung kanilang capability. Pero ang gagaling nila, no? Especially sa technology. But then, kailangan din, as we give them responsibility, we also give them help, no? Support. Otherwise, we will be overestimating their experience. Akala natin kaya na nila at papabayaan na natin sila. That is overestimating their experience. They haven't experienced enough actually, no? But they are very capable in many respects. So, kailangan balansehin natin. We let them do things na kaya nila and then we help them along the way, no? As they magnify their responsibility. I remember a story by Elder Henry B. Eyring. No, when he shared the story of a timid, shy deacon's quorum counselor, no, who was assigned to visit and bring another inactive deacon to church. So, no, nung na-assign nga na yun, sabi nga nung pagkatapos ng meeting, parang mabagal na naglakad yung na-assign na counselor sa deacon's quorum papunta roon sa inactive na kapwa niya deacon. But then, after few minutes, lumabas yung deacon, kasama na niya yung inactive na deacon. And the scenario was repeated several times. No, naging magkaibigan itong dalawa ito, and then naging active itong dating inactive na deacon. And then many years after that, sabi ni Elder Eyring, nakita niya yung lolo ng dating deacon na ito. No? And then sabi niya, Elder Eyring, I would like you to know, I am the grandfather of that deacon, no, na nireactivate, no, ng kapwa niya deacon at that time. I would like you to know, sabing ganon, na my grandson still remembers and very grateful dun sa effort na yun. So, yeah, napakaganda, no, brothers and sisters, my dear young friends, napakagandang opportunity na binibigay sa atin, no, to really develop yung ating leadership skills. Young as you are, the Lord is trusting you, no, na magagawa ninyo yung mga responsibilities na binibigay sa inyo if only you are willing to magnify them. There are three areas of the standards that I feel the need to re-emphasize these days. I do this out of my love and concern for all our youth. These three are interconnected. 1. Dating. 2. Sexual intimacy. 3. Entertainment and media. Let's consider dating. According to this handbook, no, I would like to emphasize this para hindi tayo malilito, no, sa standards ng Panginoon at ng simbahan. Sabi dito, a date is a planned activity that allows a young man and a young woman to get to know each other better. It can help you learn and practice social skills, develop friendships, have wholesome fun, and eventually find an eternal partner. So, napakaganda ng purpose ng dating. You should not date until you're at least 16 years old. When you begin dating, go with one or more additional couples. Avoid going on frequent dates with the same person. Developing serious relationships too early in life can limit the number of other people you meet and can perhaps lead to immorality. Invite your parents to become acquainted with those you date. So in other words, when our young people date, it's not a steady dating. It's a group date. Steady dating means dating the same person again and again. So that is steady na. And then you have mutual understanding na parang kayo na. And that is very dangerous, no? And then sabi rito, choose to date only those who have high moral standards and in whose company you can maintain your standards. Remember that a young man and a young woman on a date are responsible to protect each other's honor and virtue. Okay, sabi rito, plan dating activities that are safe, positive, and inexpensive, and that will help you get to know each other. Go only to places where you can maintain your standards and remain close to the spirit. So, we have to be very careful, no? Kung magde-date tayo, marami tayong kasama, hindi tayo nag-iisa o hindi lang tayong dalawa, and then we go to places that will not compromise our standards, no? And then sabi rito, as you enter your adult years, make dating and marriage a high priority. So, ibig sabihin, when the time comes na you are old enough to prepare or to be married, so then you can have serious dating activities, no? So, I hope that will be clear, no, sa ating mga youth na nakikinig. And also, as a guide sa ating mga parents sa standards na ating Panginoon sa dating. Now, let me move to another topic on the standards. Sabi rito, sexual intimacy. So again, napaka-importante nito and I feel our youth should be reminded, no, ng standard ng Panginoon regarding this. Sabi rito, no, physical intimacy between husband and wife is beautiful and sacred. It is ordained of God for the creation of children and for the expression of love between husband and wife. God has commanded that sexual intimacy be reserved for marriage. So there is a time for that, no? So napakaganda ng power na binigay ni Heavenly Father sa atin to be partners with Him in creating in sending His children here, no, yung mga spirit children niya, and then us giving them body, no? So that is the power of procreation. Napakaganda niyan, and that is part of Heavenly Father's plan. But that should be reserved for marriage, no? When you are sexually pure, you prepare yourself to make and keep sacred covenants in the temple. You prepare yourself to build a strong marriage and to bring children into the world as part of an eternal and loving family. You protect yourself from the spiritual and emotional damage that come from sharing sexual intimacy outside of marriage. You also protect yourself from harmful diseases. Remaining sexually pure helps you to be confident and truly happy and improves your ability to make good decisions now and in the future. So, let us consider the Lord's standard on sexual intimacy. No? Sabi, the Lord's standard regarding sexual purity is clear and unchanging. Do not have any sexual relations before marriage and be completely faithful to your spouse after marriage. Do not allow the media, your peers, or others to persuade you that sexual intimacy before marriage is acceptable. It is not. In God's sight, sexual sins are extremely serious. They defile the sacred power God has given us to create life. The prophet Alma taught that sexual sins are more serious than any other sins except murder or denying the Holy Ghost. So, napaka-seryoso pong issue yan, ano? There are processes sa mga members who will violate, no, yung law of chastity, because that is a serious matter as far as the Lord is concerned, no? And then let's continue, no? Never do anything that could lead to sexual transgression. Treat others with respect, not as objects used to satisfy lustful and selfish desires. Before marriage, do not participate in passionate kissing, lie on top of another person, or touch the private sacred parts of another person's body with or without clothing. Do not do anything else that arouses sexual feelings. Do not arouse those emotions in your own body. Pay attention to the promptings of the Spirit so that you can be clean and virtuous. The Spirit of the Lord will withdraw from one who is in sexual transgression. So, napakahalaga na maintindihan ng ating mga youth ito, no? On sa standards ng Panginoon to keep ourselves pure. And then, I'll continue, no? Gusto ko talagang maintindihan natin ito and then ma-remind tayo, no? Sa napakahalagang aspect na ito ng standard ng Panginoon. Sabi nito, avoid situations that invite increased temptation, such as late night or overnight activities away from home, or activities where there is a lack of adult supervision. Do not participate in discussions or any media that arouse sexual feelings. Do not participate in any type of pornography. The Spirit can help you know when you are at risk and give you the strength to remove yourself from the situation. Have faith in and be obedient to the righteous counsel of your parents and leaders. Okay, so in relation to sexual intimacy, sabi rito, homosexual and lesbian behavior is a serious sin. If you find yourself struggling with same gender attraction or you are being persuaded to participate in inappropriate behavior, seek counsel from your parents and bishop. They will help you. So, malinaw po rito yan, ano? So, yung homosexual and lesbian behavior is a serious sin, no? But of course, we understand yung mga tao, no? And even members who have this challenge, yung tinatawag na same gender attraction, no? So, we respect them and we recognize yung kanilang challenge and we try to help them, no, sa kanilang pinagdadaanan. Now, sabi rito, if you are tempted to commit any form of sexual transgression, seek help from your parents and bishop. Pray to your Father in heaven who will help you resist temptation and overcome inappropriate thoughts and feelings. If you have committed serious transgression, talk to your bishop now and begin the process of repentance so that you can find peace and have the full companionship of the Spirit. Make a personal commitment to be sexually pure. By your words and actions, encourage others to do the same. So, brothers and sisters, malinaw po yung standard ng Panginoon. I have read this para hindi po tayo malilito, no? And we will not be deceived by what is being taught by the social media nowadays. Now, let's move sa entertainment and media. The last of the three items na gusto kong i-discuss sa standards, no? Sabi rito, choose wisely when using media because whatever you read, listen to, or look at has an effect on you. Select only media that uplifts you. Satan uses media to deceive you by making what is wrong and evil look normal, humorous, or exciting. He tries to mislead you into thinking that breaking God's commandments is acceptable and has no negative consequences for you or others. Do not attend, view, or participate in anything that is vulgar, immoral, violent, or pornographic in any way. Do not participate in anything that presents immorality or violence as acceptable. Have the courage to walk out of a movie, change your music, or turn off a computer, television, or mobile device if what you see or hear drives away the spirit. Pornography in all forms is especially dangerous and addictive. What may begin as an unexpected exposure or a curious exploration can become a destructive habit Use of pornography is a serious sin and can lead to other sexual transgression. Avoid pornography at all costs. It is a poison that weakens your self-control, destroys your feelings of self-worth, and changes the way you see others. It causes you to lose the guidance of the spirit and can damage your ability to have a normal relationship with others, especially your future spouse. It limits your ability to feel true love. If you encounter pornography, turn away from it immediately. So, brothers and sisters, this is another challenge, no, that our generation is facing, a very difficult challenge. So I hope malinaw po sa atin ano yung standard ng Panginoon, and we will have the courage, no, na sundin ito. I know the challenge is very real, no, kaya better na makinig tayo, no, na sa mga sinasabi ng mga leaders natin. And then sabi rito, no, take care that your use of media does not dull your sensitivity to the spirit or interfere with your personal relationships with others. Spending long periods of time using the internet or a mobile device, playing video games, or watching television or other media can keep you from valuable interactions with other people. Be careful that your use of social media does not replace spending time with your family and friends. If you are not sure whether something is appropriate to watch or listen to, talk to your parents and other adult leaders. The Holy Ghost will give you strength to make correct choices. As I said, these three are interconnected. If these standards are followed, they will lead to moral purity and happiness. If not, it can lead to sin, unhappiness, and untimely pregnancy for our young girls. So let's consider this teenage pregnancy. So this has become a phenomenon, you know, sa ating panahon. Sabi nga, teenage pregnancies or births from girls age below 19 years old. This phenomenon is now declared a national social emergency in the Philippines. And I think the trend is also the same in many parts of the world. So, yung mga nabubuntis below the age of 19 years old, no? And then in the Philippines, sabi, the number of teenage pregnancies increased by 7% in 2019 to 62,510, a steady increase in the last 9 years. So in the last 9 years, the trend is patas ng patas. Now, of these births, 2,411 are from mothers ages 10 to 14, a threefold increase since 2000. So imagine po natin, brothers and sisters, I would like to relate this problem, this social problem, no, dito sa tatlo na binanggit ko, sa problems na binanggit ko na tatlong ito, ano, doon sa standards, if we disobey the standards of sexual purity, of dating, of entertainment, and use of social media, magkakaproblema po talaga tayo, no, as a society. And I hope not, no, as a church. That's why we are issuing this warning voice sa ating mga youth and tell them, no, yung dire consequences sa kanilang buhay if they disregard this very important counsel from the Lord and from the leaders. So, sabi rito, globally, complications from pregnancy and childbirth are the leading cause of death among adolescent girls. Untimely pregnancy and childbirth hampers the education, career, employment, and economic well-being of the families of young mothers. So, napakaraming masasacrifice, napakaraming maapektuhan sa kinabukasan ng ating mga kabataan if they become complacent, no, complacent about this very important standard ng Panginoon. So sana po, no, ang ating mga young, ating mga youth will see, no, sa danger, no, ng kanilang mga nasa paligid, and they will consider their ways, no. So I understand talaga, no, na itong nangyayari, itong phenomenon, no, na teenage pregnancy ay dahil sa permissiveness ng society, no, at access ng ating mga kabataan sa mga social media, no, na nakikita nila yung mga hindi dapat makita at malaman sa social media. And as they see sa social media, they act out, no, in their dating, in their relationship with opposite sex, no. So mga bata pa, they have already romance, no, yung mga romantic relationship. Kaya nagkakaproblema tayo dito, no. Ito ang tawag, teenage pregnancy. Whereas nakikita natin dito, hindi na hindi lang teenage ito, age of 10 is not yet teenage, no. So 10 age pregnancy malamang ang nangyayari dito, the age of 10, not yet teen, no. Let's proceed sa regular youth interviews. This is another aspect of youth programs, no, na malaking tulong sa ating mga kabataan. So again, I'd like to read on the and emphasize on the role of parents, no. Sabi rito, parents have the primary responsibility for teaching their children the gospel of Jesus Christ. They help their children grow spiritually and prepare to make and keep sacred covenants. Parents also counsel with their children regarding worthiness and help them repent and improve. Bishops and other church leaders support parents in these efforts. So napakahalagang maintindihan natin na it is not actually the primary responsibility, no, of church leaders as far as interviews are concerned, or helping our children, our young generation, no, understand doctrines and principles. So nasa sa parents po ang responsibility talaga, na we can have informal talks, no, sa ating mga anak. We can have bonding, no, or good time with our children para they will open up to us, no. And ating pong responsibility talaga yan as parents. So our leaders only support sa aspect of many things sa buhay ng ating mga anak. So sabi rito, no, the bishop or one of his counselors will interview the young man or young woman at least twice a year. A bishopric member may also meet with youth to answer questions, give support, or extend assignments. To help youth prepare spiritually, interviews are required for sacred matters such as temple recommends, priesthood ordinations, and mission calls. Leaders work with parents to help youth prepare for these interviews. Parents encourage their children to meet with a bishop when they need his help with spiritual guidance or with repentance. If a youth desires, he or she may invite a parent or another adult to be present when meeting with a bishop or one of his counselors. So napakaraming times, no, na a bishop member, bishopric member will interview a young man or a young woman. So which is good, no, dahil at least maraming opportunities, no, na matulungan, magabayan, ano, yung ating mga kabataan. And given the responsibility now of the bishopric para sa mga youth, mas nagiging focus talaga ng bishopric ito ngayon, ano, to really be with our youth and talk to them, ano, whether in interview settings or in informal settings such as activities. So, and then and another important thing about sa interviews, pwede na po kayong sumama, no, sa youth interview ng inyong anak. So, you can sit in, no, doon sa bishop's office if you want. No? And this is also part of protecting our young men and young women. So let's proceed dun sa ating temple and family history aspect of youth programs, no? So interestingly, you will note, brothers and sisters, that symbols and emblems for children and youth point them early to the temple. No, yung kanta nga, while I am in my early years, I'll prepare most carefully so I can marry in God's temple for eternity. So, sa atin lang kinakanta yan, no? Tayo lang kumakanta yan. Na young as 8, no? Kinakanta na nila about marriage, about the future of marrying in the temple. So, saan ka nakakita niya na bata pa ay pag-aasawa na ang pinag-uusapan, no? Sa temple. So, anyway, so you will see, no? Let's consider itong mga tokens and emblems ng ating mga youth. So, let's start with the CTR ring. Dati, CTR ring ang familiar sa atin. Ngayon, we have this ring. Tingnan niyo yung symbol ng ring. For those turning 8 years old, bibigyan po sila niyan. And also, as they turn 8, bibigyan sila ng poster ng temple. No? And as they turn to youth, tignan ninyo yung necklace and pendant for all young women turning 12 years old. The temple emblem is there. Doon sa mga young men natin turning 12, there is this ring. And you can see the emblem there is also temple. All turning 12, as they receive yung kanilang temple recommend, yung limited use recommend after interview, they'll be given this plastic cover, no? Of a temple recommend, no? So, si Jesus Christ, which is all about the temple, no? And then, as they graduate, sa young women, they'll be given this pendant in addition dun sa kanilang necklace. So, dadagdagan ng pendant yan. Again, you can see the symbol of the temple. And then, yung oil vial for young men turning 18. No, as they receive the Melchizedek priesthood, they'll be given the oil vial, no, para magamit nila in administering to the sick and the afflicted. So, you see the symbol of the temple again. So, brothers and sisters, ano, talagang the Lord is helping our young people to focus and center their lives in the temple, wherein they will receive yung highest ordinances, no, for exaltation. So, kaya nga sabi rito, no, temple and family history aspect of youth program, all 11 to 18 year old priesthood holders and baptized members may receive limited use recommend valid for 1 year. And they can do proxy baptisms and they can witness proxy baptisms. Yung mga priest natin can baptize, no, in proxy baptisms. Lahat ng youth natin are encouraged to do family history work, including yung indexing. And you will see that an assistant to the priest quorum and a member of the young women class presidency ay member na ng ward, temple, and family history council. So, in relation doon sa indexing, makikita po natin yung napakagandang achievement ng ating mga youth. And hopefully, we can continue this. This will be an ongoing process, no, na they will be involved sa indexing. So, nakapag-index po sila in a span of few months, no, 1,043 records. So, that's times 6, that would be about 6,000 names, no, na pwedeng maging maipabaptize sa temple. No? And we have 13 young women who participated and 13 young men and 14 young women nag-participate doon sa indexing. So, napakaganda po niyan. So, again, sabi ko nga rito, ito ngayon yung Temple and Family History Coordination Council. So, makikita niyo po dyan, yung priest quorum assistant ay member, as well as yung young women class presidency member, no? So kasama niyo yung Eldest Quorum President, Relief Society President, member ng presidency, no? And then yung Temple and Family History Leader, and then yung ating mga Family History Consultants. So nandyan na yung mga youth natin. So napakaganda, no? Napakaganda ng program ng Panginoon sa para sa mga youth, no? As they prepare to enter the temple. Now let's listen to what Elder Bednar, no, has to say about the role of youth sa ating mga role of youth sa temple and family history work. Now, sabi niya, your fingers have been trained to text and tweet to accelerate and advance the work of the Lord, not just to communicate quickly with your friends. The skills and attitude evident among many young people today are a preparation to contribute to the work of salvation. So additionally, ito yung sinabi ni Elder Bednar as read by Arjo and Riza.
Elder David A. Bednar said, quote, as you respond in faith with this invitation, your heart shall turn to the fathers. This promise made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will be implanted in your hearts. Your patriarchal blessings, its declaration of lineage, will link you to these fathers and be more meaningful to you. Your love and your gratitude to your ancestor will increase.
Your testimony of and conversion to the Savior will become deep and abiding. And I promise you will be protected against the intensifying influence of the adversary. As you participate in and love this holy work, you will be safeguarded in your youth and throughout your lives. Close quote.
Let's now proceed sa young men, ano, yung priesthood ordination. As you can see here, John the Baptist restoring the Aaronic priesthood to Joseph Smith and Oliver Cowdery.
Upon you, my fellow servants, in the name of Messiah, I confer the priesthood of Aaron, which holds
the key of the ministering of angel and of the gospel of preference,
and of baptizing by immersion of the remission of sins.
And this shall never be taken again from the earth, until the sons of Levi do offer again an offering unto the Lord in righteousness.
As far as our priesthood ordination is concerned, we have 53 young men in the list, and only about 20 are ordained to the proper priesthood office. And of the 30-something not ordained to the proper priesthood office, only 8 are conferred the Aaronic priesthood. The rest are not priesthood holders at all. So brothers and sisters, this is one of the goals of the bishopric, you know. We will help prepare our young men to receive the Aaronic priesthood and to be ordained to the proper priesthood office. What a blessing, no, to be able to exercise the priesthood as they prepare, pass, and bless and pass the sacrament and do baptisms, no, and many other things na pwede nilang gawin, because they hold the Aaronic priesthood. And as we can see, the Aaronic priesthood is the preparatory priesthood. It will help them be prepared to receive the higher priesthood, the Melchizedek priesthood, and make themselves available, no, in a lifelong commitment to serve our Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ. Another important aspect of being a youth is mission preparation. This is personal to me. As I said before, maybe one reason I was called a bishop at this time is so I can help our youth, especially our young men, to prepare to serve a full-time mission. Nothing is more important for them at this time of their life. The call to serve, Full-time missionary service is a privilege for members who are called through inspiration by the president of the church. Missionary service is literally service to the Lord and His church. Its objective is not primarily the personal development of a missionary, although righteous service invariably produces that result. This calling is extended only to those who are worthy and able to accomplish it. Missionary service demands faith, desire, and consecration. Missionary candidates should have an eagerness and a desire to serve the Lord as His ambassadors. They should be filled with faith, hope, charity, and love, and have an eye single to the glory of God.
The Lord expects each able young man to prepare spiritually, physically, mentally, emotionally, and financially for missionary service. Personal preparation includes studying the gospel and the scriptures, especially the Book of Mormon, and building a testimony.
Preparing missionaries should be a high priority for parents, leaders, and teachers. Bishop and stake presidents have a special important responsibility to identify and prepare working qualified members for missionary service.
They give special attention to helping young men prepare, especially those who seem uncertain about serving, and to helping young women prepare when they have a desire to serve.
In relation to mission preparation, I have come up with this Mission Muna mentoring program, wherein it is listed all areas, ano, that I think will be very helpful para sa ating mga young men, sa ating mga young women in preparing to serve a full-time mission. So as you run through, no, reading through this list, makikita nyo po rito, no, yung napakahalagang mga aspeto ng scripture study, and then Sabbath day worship, and then participating in activities, no, and then nandyan din po yung pagiging member missionary, and many aspects, no, yung kanilang savings program, and the participation sa family history work, and then yung regular interview. Then we also have the physical aspect of preparation. Meron din dyan patriarchal blessing and many other things. So as you read through, makikita po ninyo na maraming mga bagay na dapat i-prepare. Kaya as early as primary or pagkapasok sa young men, talagang we will try to help, start helping them, no, really prepare sa kanilang mission. And Elder Bednar, no, sabi nga niya, what can I do to prepare most effectively?
What can I do to prepare most effectively to serve as a full-time missionary? My dear young brethren, the single most important thing you can do to prepare for a call to serve is to become a missionary long before you go on a mission. Please notice that in my answer, I emphasize becoming rather than going.
On the financial aspect of preparation, sabi rito, no, the primary responsibility to provide financial support for missionary service lies with the individuals serving and their families. Generally, missionaries should not rely entirely on people outside of their families to finance missionary service. Missionaries and their families should make appropriate sacrifices to help cover the cost of missionary service. It is better for a person to delay a mission for a time and earn money toward the cost of missionary service than to rely entirely on others. However, worthy missionary candidates should not be prevented from serving missions solely for financial reasons when they and their families have sacrificed according to their capability. So napakahalaga nating maintindihan na kaya kailangan maaga pa lang talaga i-prepare na natin yung ating mga anak, because the responsibility to finance a mission is galing sa sarili and then sa family. Kung kukulangin pa, is other members can help, no? But basically, the primary responsibility lies in the individual serving and their family and his family, no? So let me show you some computation, no? To give you an idea doon sa amount needed for a full-time mission. So the cost of full-time mission for men for 24 months, for example, 12,000 a month, that would be 288,000, no? For 24 months. For women, 18 months, that would be 216,000. So, titignan natin, no? Kung ang bata will prepare 10 years ahead, no? At age 8, at maghuhulog siya 10 pesos a day sa kanyang mission muna fund, times 365, 10 pesos, that would be 36,500. So, kung dadoblehin niya, gawin niyang 20 pesos, in 10 years, daily savings, makakasave siya ng 73,000 pesos. That is one-third, no, ng kanyang mission requirement. And then, kung magiging 50 pesos ang kanyang isa-save daily, that will be 182,500. Much, much better, no? Kesa dun sa wala na dahil hindi siya nakaipon ng mas maaga. So at least with this computation, we can see, no, na talagang malaking may tutulong, no, sa pag-finance ng mission. At kung kukulangin, definitely kulang yan, so other members can help, no, para makapag-mission ng ating mga young men, ating mga young women. So, andyan yung computation, no? Kung mag-start siya at age 12, 7 years, so, ayan ang kanyang may ipon. 25,000, 51,000, or kung 50 pesos daily, 127,000. Almost half, no? Ng kanyang mission expense. So, what are some things that we can consider to help our young men, young women, no, financially prepare for full-time mission? So, first thing is yung mission muna savings program. Gaya ng na-explain ko na, no, yung computation. And then, we're planning to have this YES program sa ating mga youth. YES means Youth, Enterprise, and Service. Ginagawa po ito natin dati na tinuturuan natin ang mga youth na mag-business. At in two instances na ginawa natin yon, nakaipo naman sila or nakabenta naman sila. And I hope they enjoyed, no, yung experience of earning, no, doon sa kanilang business na ginawa. So, this will encourage our youth to engage in small business or service activities that will allow them to earn for their mission and other needs. War youth specialists will help in identifying business and service opportunities from ward members. So, magko-call po tayo ng mga youth specialists. Ang gagawin lang po nila ay kausapin ang mga member, no? At mag-isip ng mga pwedeng maging business opportunities para sa mga youth. And then dun sa mga members, yung mga mayroong gustong ipagawa ng mga project, and then they will give some amount, no, sa ating mga youth, parang ipo nila or magamit nila sa kanilang pag-aaral or primarily sa kanilang pag-mission. And also we will encourage our youth to seek part-time job or livelihood opportunities. No, so pwede sila magtrabaho ng mga kaya nila, no? And then they can have business also of their own. Kagaya ng ginagawa ng ilan natin mga priest ngayon, no, who are selling products. Napakagandang training 'yan para sa kanila. And then also, we can have members, no, give to the Ward Missionary Fund. So in relation dun sa Ward Missionary Fund, brothers and sisters, ano, ito yung ginagamit natin to finance, to help finance yung mga missionaries natin na galing sa ward. So, if you will notice, as I see the records, the fund is in deficit for the past 6 years in the total amount of 270,000 as of December 2020. So, this means that the financial commitment of the full-time missionaries and their families are not being met, and that the members are not contributing as much sa ating Ward Missionary Fund. So this is a concern, brothers and sisters, no, na meron tayo mga missionaries na nagsaserve na hindi nakapagbibigay ng kanilang committed amount, no, sa kanilang mission. So I hope you can provide some course correction measures, no, para i-address itong concern na ito. Before I end this topic on mission preparation, I would like to share with you a song entitled, I'll Go and Find You, My Friend. It had greatly influenced me in deciding to serve a full-time mission. It had opened my eyes to see my premortal existence with a call to go and find my friends on earth, which I believe I did as I shared the gospel to the good people of Samar and Leyte in 1992 to 1994, and as I continue to do so as I strive to serve others.
One of the greatest things na nakuha ko sa pagsiserve ng mission is yung knowledge. Yung pinakauna sa lahat is yung knowledge. Pangalawa is yung experience. So, dun sa knowledge, mas nag-broaden yung knowledge ko, mas naging deeper yung knowledge ko about sa Ebanghelyo ni Jesu Cristo. Because the more that we teach, the more that we learn. So, kumbaga, as missionary, everyday tayong magtuturo. Everyday kami magtuturo sa mga investigators. So, syempre, yung knowledge namin is nag-grow din siya while we teach. And also, nag-aaral kami everyday. No? Nag-scripture study kami everyday. Nagpa-planning kami. So, lahat ng ginagawa namin preparation no, para sa pagtuturo. And pangalawa na natutunan ko or nakuha ko is yung experience nga. Because 2 years of experience dun sa mission is equivalent to 20 years of experience dito sa mundo. No? So, kumbaga, yun yung idea ko. Kasi sa mission is may experience mo lahat ng klase ng experience na magagamit mo pag uwi mo. Kumbaga, magagamit mo as a returned missionary. So, yun lang, no? Yung knowledge, saka yung experience. Lahat na ito, gusto kong iwan sa pangalan ni Jesu Cristo. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, I'd like to bear to you my testimony that the church is really true. In spite of the pandemic that we have, the Lord still loves us in spite of this. We, members of the church, are guided to know the commandments of the Lord. Sa mission, marami tayong mga bagay na na-experience na nakakatulong sa ating buhay. Mga nag-mission, malaking bagay po ito, nakatulong po sa akin, lalong-lalo na sa aking pamilya. Kaya ni-encourage ko po kayo, brothers and sisters, na we need to keep the commandments. We need to learn how to love the Lord. We need to know that in spite of this, the Lord still loves us. At iiwan ko ito sa inyo sa lahat ng members na nakikinig o makakapanood dito. Through the name of Jesus Christ, Amen.
Nagpapasalamat po ako sa pagkakataon na ipinigay ni Bishop para mag-share po ng testimony about sa blessing as full-time missionary. Isa po sa mga pinaka-greatest blessing na na-receive ko is yung pagkakaroon po ng eternal family. Pagkaroon po namin ng 4 na anak na kung saan ay na-guide din po namin sila at lumaki sila sa church. Nagpapasalamat po ako sa gospel na meron kami sa buhay namin na kung saan na-apply ko po ito sa aking mga anak. At sila din po na habang lumalaki, nakikita ko kung paano din nila i-apply ang Ebanghelyo ni Jesu Cristo sa kanilang buhay. Lumaki po silang mabait at naging active po sa church. Nakita ko rin sa kanila yung desire na mag-serve ng mission at mag-share ng gospel sa mga tao. Nagpapasalamat din po ako sa experience ko sa mission na yun din ang nakatulong sa akin kung paano ako maging hindi man perfect mom pero paano ako maging nanay sa kanila. At isa po sa mga pinaka lesson na natutunan ko nang ako'y nasa mission na palagi pong tinuturo sa amin at nire-remind sa amin ng aming mga leaders at saka ng aming mission president. Ang saying na sinabi ni Prophet Joseph Smith, yung obey first before you complain. So alam ko na kapag sinunod natin ito, ay magiging blessed ang buhay natin. At lalo na po sa ating mga youth, na alam naman natin sa panahon ngayon, kapag na inuutusan natin sila, ang madalas marinig natin ay, wait lang, saglit lang, mamaya na. Or magre-reklamo muna bago susunod sa inuutos sa kanila. Pero dapat po tandaan natin yung tinuturo sa atin na obey first before we complain. Dahil alam natin na ang kasunod doon ay blessing na marireceive natin. Gaya po ng stripling warriors na palagi nilang isinaisip yung itinuturo ng magulang o ng nanay sa kanila na obedience with exactness. Alam ko po na ang mga kapag ginawa natin ito, mabibless po tayo. At nagpapasalamat po ako sa pagkakataon na binigyan ako na mag-serve ng mission at nakareceive ako ng mga blessing sa buhay ko. Alam ko ang mga bagay nito ay totoo at iniiwan ko ito sa pangalan ni Jesus Christ. Amen.
Sa blessings na natutunan ko sa after sa aking mission o sa mission ko ay natutunan ko kung paano magmahal sa aking kapwa-tao. So yung pagmamahal na yan ay na-develop ko yan hanggang ngayon na at binigyan ko ito ng kahalagahan. At alam ko na isa ito sa kautusan ng Diyos na kailangan mong mahalin ng iyong kapwa-tao. So, may mga pagkakataon na may nakikita ko ng mga tao sa paligid na minsan naaawa ako at hindi ko minsan ay talagang kumbaga gusto ko silang tulungan kasi nga pag tiningnan ko sila, lalo-lalo na yung mga bata na nasa lansangan, yung mga magulang na nasa lansangan, humihingi ng tulong sa mga dumadaan ng mga sasakyan. Minsan naisip ko rin na kailangan mo silang tulungan dahil anak din sila ng Diyos. So, yung pagmamahal na yan ay isa yung blessing na natutunan ko nung nasa mission field ba ako. Kaya nga, kung nasa mission tayo ay isa yung dahilan kung bakit tayo nag-mission dahil mahal natin ang ating kapwa-tao at gusto natin itong makabalik sa kaharian ng Diyos. So, alam ko na mahalaga po ito na gagawin natin bawat isa sa atin dahil ang Diyos din ay nag-uutos sila sa atin na dapat tayo ay marunong magmahal at ipakita natin sa ating mga kapwa na concerned tayo sa kanila na mahal natin sila. Ito pong maikli kong mensahe para sa lahat. Pinapatutuhanan ko po na isa itong blessing na hanggang ngayon ay na-enjoy ko at naramdaman ko sa aking sarili. Ito po ay iniiwan ko sa pangalan ni Jesucristo. Amen.
Let me move to patriarchal blessing. So this patriarchal blessing has historical beginning doon sa time ni Jacob and blessing each of his sons, no, yung 12 tribes of Israel. And this is considered as a personal revelation, given to those who receive the patriarchal blessing. So according to President Monson, in some of his talks discussing patriarchal blessing, narito po yung napakagandang blessings, no, ng patriarchal blessing. So we can know our lineage, no, kung saan tayo belong sa 12 tribes of Israel. A patriarchal blessing is a revelation to the recipient, a personal revelation, no, para sa kanya. And then sabi, it is your passport to peace. So many times you will really feel, no, yung comfort from the Holy Ghost. Especially in trying and difficult times, when you read your patriarchal blessing, no, maramdaman mo talaga agad yung kapayapaan. It is a white line in the middle of the road, no, so talagang guide. Hindi tayo ma-distract, no. Meron tayong pwedeng sundan, no, wherein we can be safe. Pag sininod natin yun. Sabi rito, patriarchal blessing is a chapters in your eternal possibilities. No? So maraming mga promises na nakalagay doon on condition of obedience, these promises will be fulfilled, no? So there are many possible things na pwede mangyari. And then patriarchal blessing is our personal liyahona, no? So it's personal to us, it will give us direction, ano, kung ano yung tatahakin natin sa buhay natin as we make decisions, no, important decisions sa buhay natin. And finally, brothers and sisters, of all these things, programs and activities that are being held, no, sa ating simbahan, there is this desire, no, to safeguard or protect our children and youth. So I think our parents should understand this, pati na mga youth natin, no? When adults are interacting with children and youth in church settings, at least two responsible adults should be present. It may be necessary for quorums to meet together to make this possible. All adults who work with youth must complete the children and youth protection training within 1 month of being sustained. They repeat the training every 3 years thereafter. So ganito kaseryoso ang church, no? To really ensure, no, that our children and youth are guarded and protected, no, against dangers, even inside the church, no? So napaka-importante po niyan. And also to protect our leaders, those who lead the youth, no, will also be protected. So mutual protection po yan ng mga leaders as well as our children and youth. So in summary, brothers and sisters, no, I have discussed many things and I hope you have appreciated, no, yung pagmamahal ni Heavenly Father sa atin in giving us these programs and initiatives para sa development ng ating mga youth. So napaka-importante po na ma-appreciate natin ito and hopefully have the desire na maisagawa natin ito sa buhay ng ating mga kabataan. So yung ating mga youth will be willing and receptive, no, to avail of these programs and initiatives from the church. And our parents and their guardians will have the desire, no, and even continue to sacrifice to support our youth and children as they prepare, no, sa kanilang napakahalagang mission na gaganapin now and in the future. So of all these things na diniscuss ko, maraming natutuhan, maraming nalaman, maraming mga gagawin. But this cannot happen, ano, without us making the decision for ourselves. So I'd like to share a scripture, no, in Doctrine and Covenants section 58.
Verily I say, men should be anxiously engaged in a good cause,
and do many things of their own free will, and to pass much righteousness.
For the power is in them, wherein they are agents unto themselves.
And inasmuch as men do good, they shall in no wise lose their reward. DNC 58.
So, gusto ko lang i-share sa inyo yung testimony ko, no? Kasi, marami yan actually, no? From what Sister Amy mentioned, na mga kailangan nating i-consider as youth. In addition doon sa mga sinabi rin ni MJ, napakarami, no? Napakarami talaga. And I feel for you kasi nakikita ko talaga yung hirap din ng mga youth natin of so many things na kailangan nilang gawin, of so many things that are expected of them. And I can also feel for the parents kung ano yung challenge na meron talaga sila ngayon, especially in dealing, no, yung sa pagpapalaki ng kanilang mga children, ng kanilang mga anak. To the point na there was a time, no, na naramdaman ko because during that time, I was really emphasizing lahat ng mga bagay na dapat gawin, especially sa seminary and many other things, ano, na alam ko na makakatulong sa mga youth. So given this feeling at saka yung nararamdaman ko para sa mga parents, para sa mga youth, sabi ko, ano kaya? Bawasan kaya natin yung ano, yung pangungulit sa mga bata of so many things na kailangan nilang gawin. Ano kaya bawasan? And I try to contemplate on that. No? So I remember I was at my office, bishop's office, ano, trying to contemplate on that. But you know, brothers and sisters, there was something, no, telling me na don't do it. I have shared this impression sa ilan sa inyong mga youth, how I felt at that time, as if a message, no, is telling me, don't do it. Huwag mong bawasan yung pinapagawa mo mga sa mga youth. Do not stop telling them or huwag mo silang tigilan sa mga alam mo na dapat nilang gawin. And, as if I feel ano na sinasabi na in fact you should let them do many things, especially at this stage of their life. Kaya nga yung binanggit ni MJ dyan, ano yung let us be anxiously engaged in a good cause and do many things of our own free will. So, brothers and sisters, I testify yung mga binanggit sa inyo ngayon na mga dapat gawin ng mga youth para sa panahon na ito, I testify ito yung makakatulong sa inyo. Do not leave Satan anymore. No, yung time to tempt you, to waste your time. Huwag nyo nang hayaan si Satan na gumamit ng panahon ninyo. No, so, kaya I have that impression ano, na parang sinasabi sa akin, instead of backing off, continue to tell them what to do, kung ano yung dapat nilang gawin. Dahil I would like them to be busy in good causes, sa mga magaganda, sa mga productive na mga gawain. So, kaya that is my testimony sa inyo na pag ginawa nyo ito, itong counsel na ito na narinig nyo ngayon sa inyong mga leaders, I know the Lord will bless you. Sa mga parents na nandito, I know mahirap sa inyo yan. On top of many responsibilities that you have, pero hindi po kayo pagkakatiwalaan ng Diyos to have that responsibility kung hindi niya alam na hindi niyo kaya. So alam po na you have been chosen to raise up itong generation na ito dahil malaki ang tiwala niya sa inyo. So I testify that our youth will perform very important work para sa Panginoon in the near future, now and in the near future. So sana i-guide natin sila at turuan natin sila. So I'd like to share this testimony with you, with my blessing sa inyo, dear parents, at saka my dear youth, that the Lord will help you sa inyong mga gagawin, sa inyong mga ginagawa. To prepare yourself, no, and to be engaged anxiously in good causes. I end with my testimony that Heavenly Father loves you and that He has a great plan for each one of you. Jesus Christ loves you. He is ever willing to help you and see you fulfill your mission on earth. He longs for you to exercise your agency to follow Him and serve others. This is an exciting time for you and all of us to live, when we are preparing for the return of Jesus Christ, and maybe to actually welcome Him in the flesh at His coming. May God bless you, my dear young friends, and your parents and family, as you unite and support one another in building an eternal family and God's kingdom here on earth. In the name of Jesus Christ, Amen.